How I took a Shopify store from $0 to $10,000 in 11 days, I wanna get into that right now. So I was able to, again, scale a store from $0 to $10,000 in 11 days using Facebook ads. That's all I did, Facebook ads, and I want to break down exactly what I did. This is an add-on to the video I did a few days ago, or like a week ago, where I explained how I scaled a store to $2,000 a day. This is the same exact store. So yeah, we're gonna get into everything, how I'm now like scaling it all up and what I'm doing, because that is the important part. This video will be about scaling. So what I do, I already explained how I test, how I get to $2,000 a day. I want to explain how I'm now scaling up to higher numbers. Like by, I think Friday, we should be at around $5,000 daily. By the week after, we should be at around $10,000 daily. So how do I do that? Basically, as I explained, we have our little test run for a few days, like 5 days, where you test 50 ad sets and get data. You should get orders, you should get tons of clicks and tons of add to carts. So you test 50 ad sets, that's how I did it. And then basically how I scaled it to 10K is understanding what ad sets are working well, so doing breakdowns and obviously filter whatever ads are working or ad sets are working, then break down by gender, by age, by location, by time of day, all of that stuff. You wanna break down and learn what is converting the best. So if you have an ad set with 20 orders or 20 purchases, and then you break down and you see that like 8 a.m. is performing really well, you have like 5 purchases that are for $5 per purchase, and you're getting like $50 purchase value, that's huge, or order value, that is huge. That's a really good time. So you could, in a sense, create an ad where it is just spending money at that time, at that exact hour. So there's a lot of stuff like that. Like, I'll get into more stuff like that in other videos, like more in-depth scaling, but front end, I mean, it's not too hard. You just look again, look through all the ad sets. Sorry, I have a cold right now. Look through the ad sets, understand which ones are performing, which ones are getting you good CPP, cost per purchase, and then basically all I'm doing is I'm taking like 5 winning ad sets and putting them into one CBO, which is a campaign budget optimization. Basically, instead of giving one ad set a budget, you give a whole campaign a budget, and then you put 5 ad sets in a budget, or in a campaign, I mean, and then the budget is spent throughout all ad sets, not evenly. It spends according to what it thinks it's is going to perform best. And with this, your ads actually have to optimize. Normally it's around 50 purchases per ad set. Sometimes it just optimizes right away if it's performing well for a few days. That's what happened to me with a few of my ad sets. So I didn't have to wait till 50 purchases, because that is a lot of revenue that I would have to generate, especially for my product. It's a higher price. It's over $50 per purchase. So in that sense, that's how I run them. Literally, I created 3 CBO campaigns, had the same exact ad sets in each campaign, and I ran them with $200 a day budget. Like, it's not very complicated. I think people overcomplicate Facebook ads a lot. I just learned them like a month ago. Literally the past month, I went from not knowing much, like obviously knowing how to create a basic ad, but now I'm understanding how I'm how to generate sales, how to scale, all this stuff, and it's all pretty simple now that I completely comprehend it. Some tips I could give to you guys is just be sure that you are getting started right away. I think a lot of people do believe that there's something else that they need to learn, when in reality it's not anything complicated. Like, I don't have internet right now. I'm trying to load up my revenue, but it's not loading right now, but I can show you guys a screenshot. This is what I did. Here's 10K, boom, 10K. This was from 11, you can see the time of day, so you know it, like I'm not faking this, but that is my revenue. One thing that's cool that we have currently installed is Zipify one-click upsells. We're getting an extra 30 bucks per purchase for the people who are actually opting into the upsell, which is like, I think it's like 1 in every 5 people are. The past few days, we've had tons of people buy multiple products, so it's been helping our revenue grow, but it's very cool to see the different things that you can implement and the different ways to increase average order value and increase conversion rate. We went from having a 0.7 conversion rate to we're now doing like a 2% conversion rate, which is huge. For the days that we were doing $1,000, we're now doing like, it's literally like 2x that. So it's awesome that we're able to optimize that. But I would say, you know, the main things for scaling is make sure you have as many upsells as you can, do email marketing, have your store branded, have, if you can, have VA do customer support, so they're replying to emails very quickly. Good customer service. Make sure you're laser focused with your ads, and make sure you're doing breakdowns and understanding what is actually working with your ads. Because your ad may say that you're spending 50 bucks on a purchase, and you may have 5 purchases that are all costing you $50. But if you break it down and realize, like, oh, males 25 to 34 are actually buying this product for $5, or they're spending, or Facebook spending $5 to get a purchase, but it's every other age range is spending a ton and not getting any purchases. So that's the reasoning behind why it says $50 instead of five. And then you would just create an ad set, 24 or 25 to 34, a male, and then just run it like that. I hope you guys understood what I was saying. I don't wanna make this video too long. I am going to be making a step-by-step strategy or like video on how I do what I do and how I start the store, how I run the ads and all that stuff in depth. I'll film it as well. It'll be like a 15-minute video, but it'll literally show everything I'm doing. So if you look forward to that, you can always subscribe to my channel and click the thumbs up button if you did enjoy this. And if you have any questions or comments, you can always drop those in the comment section below. But other than that, I will see you guys in the next video. I don't know, it should be in like 2 days or something. So yeah, look forward to that. But I will see you guys in the next video. Have a good one.